Hello all. In this video, we'll be going through the structure of a C++ program. Before going on to the exact structure, let us see how a C++ program is executed. So once a C++ code is created, it goes on to the pre-processing stage. In the pre-processing stage, the header files that are included using the preprocessor directives are added to the source file. Now, in the compilation stage, this source code gets converted into the assembly code, and the assembler converts it into the machine code that is understandable by the computer. Finally, in the linking stage, the linker links the different object files to create an executable file that helps in getting the desired output. As we understand from the execution process, there are some important parts of a C++ code without which it cannot be executed. Firstly, we have the preprocessor statement that starts with a hash symbol. These statements examines the code before actual completion begins and resolves all these directives before any code is actually generated by regular statements. The different types of preprocessor statements are inclusion, macro definition, conditional compilation, and some other directives. In the inclusion directives, we have the hash include directive, which helps in including files to our source code. Macro definition directive defines any macros that are required during the execution of a program. Conditional compilation directives acts like a flow control statements throughout the program. And we have some other directives like pragma and undef for doing their own specific functions. Pragma directive is used for defining a pragma, and undef directive is used for undefining a defined function or a macro. Following the preprocessor statement, we have the namespace definition. Namespaces are nothing but a region that provides scope for the variables, functions, data types, and many other identifiers. Usually, the namespace std is given, which contains the input-output functions that are required in the program. And finally, we have the main function where our exact code is present. Every program execution starts from the main function. Now, using the concepts that we have just discussed, here is a code snippet that shows a simple C++ program to display welcome to C++. In this code, we have all the parts that we have mentioned earlier. Firstly, we have the hash include IO stream. As I said earlier, hash include is used to include some files that are required during our execution, and this code includes IOStream, that is the file that is required for input-output statements. Next statement is for the namespace. Namespace is usually defined with the using keyword. This keyword says the compiler to use the namespace std. Next comes our main function with the int return type. Main functions can be of int return types or of void types. Void types are now obsolete, so most of the main functions are with int return type. So inside the main function, we have a statement to print welcome to C++. The keyword that is used for printing is cout, which is given in the namespace std and in the file IOStream. After that, we have the return 0 statement, which is common in all the programs. Every program execution, once successful, returns a 0. If not, it returns a 1. So usually you have a return 0 statement in all the programs for indicating successful execution. Apart from this, you can have some other parts in a C++ program, like structures, unions, functions, classes, and templates. Now, these parts
are present in program to make the readability and the compilation process easier. We will be going through all these parts in our coming sessions. I hope all of you understood the basic structure of a C++ program and will be able to write one on your own. Happy learning. Thank you.